In this video, we'll be talking about linear Diophantine equations, which comes under the topic Mathematics of Cryptography. In this video, I'll be giving a brief introduction on what the equations are, how to solve them, and we'll have two examples in the end. Cryptography is based on some specific areas of mathematics, including number theory, linear algebra, and algebraic structures. Under integer arithmetic, we have something known as linear Diophantine equations. Diophantine equation is basically a polynomial equation having two or more unknowns, such that we look for only the integer values of these unknowns. The equation is of the form ax+by equal to c and has solutions if and only if the GCD of a, b divides c. If we find one solution for this equation, we'll be able to find infinitely many solutions. Now, the GCD of a, b divides a and b, and by the condition for the solution, it divides c as well. Now, using these conditions, we can find a solution for the equation. How do we solve the equation? Okay, from the extended Euclidean algorithm, given any integers a and b, we can find integers s and t such that as+bt equals GCD of a, b. The numbers s and t need not be unique, we only need one pair. Once we have s and t, and since we are assuming that GCD of a, b divides c, there must be an integer k such that GCD of a, b into k gives me c. Now multiplying this equation all through by k, we get a into sk plus b into tk equals GCD of a, b into k, which is c. So one solution for the equation we have is x equal to sk and y equal to tk. K, as you notice, is c divided by the GCD of a, b. Now, as I said, once you have one solution, we can derive infinitely many. So how do we derive the infinite solutions? Suppose we have equation ax1+by1 equal to c, which is a solution, and another which is ax+by equal to c, which is also a solution. Taking the difference between the two, we get a into x minus x1 plus b into y minus y1 equals 0. Now, taking the b into y minus y1 on the other side, we get a into x minus x1 equals b into y minus y1. That means that a divides b into y minus y1, and therefore we can say that a divided by the GCD of a, b divides y minus y1. Now solving this equation, y1 gives y plus r into a into a by GCD of a, b for some integer r. Now substituting this into the equation a into x minus x1 equal to b into y1 minus y, gives us this, which yields x equal to x1 plus r into b by GCD of a, b. Now x1 and y1 we got from here. We have k, we have s, we can derive this. So using that and these two equations, giving various values of r ranging preferably from 0 to infinity, we can derive infinite solutions for our Diophantine equation. Now let's look at two examples. I'll start with the example which we have in our textbook. Okay, 21x plus 14y equals 35. Now in this equation, we have a equals 21, b 14, and c is 35. Using the Euclidean algorithm or any other suitable method, we get the required GCD as 7. Now 7 divides 35, so this equation has infinite integral solutions. Okay, now divide this equation, the original one, by 7 to get 3x plus 2y equals 5. Now in the new equation, we have a equals 3, b equals 2, and c equals 5. Using the extended Euclidean algorithm, we have 3s plus 2t equals GCD of 3, 2, which is 1. Solving this, we get s equals 1 and t equals minus 1. Now, as I said, the k value in our previous slide, k value is c divided by GCD of a, b. So using that here, x1 is c divided by gcd of a comma b into s, which gives me 5. y1 is c divided by gcd of a comma b into t, which gives me minus 5. And now these equations which we derived for infinitely many solutions. Now we substitute the values which we have to get x equals 5 plus 2r and y equals minus 5 minus 3r. Now giving the values of 0, 1 and 2 for this example, we get the values for x and y as the coordinates or pairs 5, comma minus 5, 7, comma minus 8 and 9, comma minus 11. This is the simple, let's say simpler example. Let's look at another example now. Okay, find all the integer solutions to 258x plus 147y equals 369. This is slightly the same method more or less, but little easier to understand. You could use it to check your solution in the end. Okay, first we have the Euclidean algorithm. We use the Euclidean algorithm to find the GCD of 147 and 258, which, as you can see from the steps, comes out to be 3. Now 3 divides 369, and hence the equation has integral solutions. Now 3 can be written in this format. I have traced this in the previous step as well, so that it's easier to follow. Now this is what we get as the final representation, and multiply by 123, because 3 into 123 gives 369. We get this. Now as you can see, x equals sk, y equals tk. So we get x equal to 492 and y equals minus 861. Now all other solutions will have the form as from the general equation, x equals 492 plus 49r and y equals minus 86r minus 861. Now this is the particular solution. Now to find the general solution, we again give values r equals 0, r equals 1 and r equals 2 to get these pairs of x and y, 492 minus 861, which was our particular solution, 541 and minus 947, 590 and minus 1033. So this was a briefing on what linear Diophantine equations are, how to solve them, the general method, and two examples as we have covered. Thank you.